Hello, everyone. Thank you for the opportunity to be with you today. I talk a little bit about myself, my path, and how I got to Hopkins, and then what I'm doing there. So I've always been interested in science as long as I can remember. As a little kid, I grew up in Miami. I wanted to go to the Miami Museum of Science every week and the summer camps. So I was so into science. And then I wanted to be a marine biologist, I think, because I liked the beach. And then and I like science, and I went to this magnet high school that was focused on marine science. But something along the way, I also thought is sort of, maybe it's through scouts. I did scouts since I was really young too, all the way through Eagle Scouts, sort of a sense of responsibility of trying to do something to help other people. And I thought that something like engineering, where I could build new technology, you know, that's something where I could apply that science and you know, help other people. And so when I went to college, I went to Carnegie Mellon. I double majored in chemical engineering and biomedical engineering to learn how to do that. And initially, I did some different research more on the chemistry side, which I liked, but didn't quite spark this passion. And then when I was a senior, I did research on gene delivery. And that really excited me, this idea of looking at medicine where one could potentially treat diseases and cure diseases on the genetic level rather than just treating the symptoms of the disease. And I really like that. And then at Carnegie Mellon, another thing that happened, different, you know, speakers come and visit like everywhere. And then there was one day where this guy, Bob Langer from MIT, came to give a talk at CMU and get this Dixon Prize. And I heard him speak and how a chemical engineer can apply things working with a doctor. He gave examples working with a neurosurgeon at Hopkins, Henry Brehm, and you know, to create these great cures, and that just captivated me. So I met with him briefly when he was there, and we stayed in touch. And then when I went to grad school, I thought this is, you know, where I need to go. And so I went to MIT. I had my PhD in biological engineering. I was in Bob's lab for my PhD and then for my postdoc. And that was a great experience, and it was everything I was looking for with the science and biomaterials and drug delivery. But the other thing I got along the way was also this bug of commercialization, which is something I didn't really think about before. But then seeing other lab mates that start companies or join venture capital, and how to create a technology and the science that if it didn't have the patent behind it and the investment, it would never be able to go on this high-risk road to actually become a product and help people. And that's what I really wanted to do. So I definitely saw that how that worked, and translation was something that was important to me. So then when I looked for different opportunities to be faculty somewhere, I was really interested in Hopkins because of the emphasis on translation, with the hospital being so integrated, and then for biomedical engineering to be so integrated in the School of Medicine. And so it's really been fantastic at Hopkins. All the people are so excellent. The students in the lab are excellent, in the classroom are excellent, the collaborators and clinicians are excellent. And I'm part of a center there, the Translational Tissue Engineering Center, which is a group of people that are all interested in regenerative medicine, developing new types of technologies and biomaterials, drug delivery, cell engineering, tissue engineering, nanotechnology, which is a great environment. We're all clustered together on a floor in the School of Medicine. And so in my lab, what we're really interested in, biomaterials and drug delivery, the same types of things I did initially as an undergrad through graduate school and postdoc, I'm still very interested in. And so there's three main areas: how we design nanoparticles and delivery systems for intracellular delivery. So to be able to find target cells, enter those cells, deliver a sensitive biological payload in the cytoplasm or the nucleus, not be degraded in endosomes or recycled back out. And so there's technologies on that. A second area is technologies for controlled release of biologics, so that the kinds of drugs that are difficult to deliver because they get cleared or degraded so quickly, that we could have a reservoir that's safely meters out the drug at a constant rate and then can treat diseases long term. And then the third area is looking at particles, not for the delivery, but to look at ways to decorate their surface, control their size and shape, so they work as artificial cells, so that biological cells see these particles and think they're biological cells and get stimulated and go off and do things because of how the biological molecules are arranged on the particle and how the particle size and shape is of a defined way. So those are three of the technologies you know, in my lab. I hope it's shown sort of how some of the BME research, how it's interdisciplinary, and how a lot of us are very interested in translation and how we can move the technology to helping people. And thank you very much for the opportunity to share with you.